Hi, this is Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado, and I have a very compelling thing I want to share with you today. In fact, it's four compelling reasons why you never want to call yourself a victim. Now, I hope you stay tuned because this is good information. Let me kind of preface that with a story I have had. I was married twice. In the first marriage, I was abandoned. I had three children. I ended up on welfare, but I didn't stay on it but when it came to doing our tax returns for the first about 3 or 4 years, my ex-husband got all of the benefits, even though they were full-time living with me, because I was on welfare, and they didn't believe that I would ever come off of welfare. Well, actually, I used it for a total of almost 2 years, and then I got remarried and obviously did not need to use welfare any further. And, of course, I'm a business owner now and earn too much money to ever be considered for welfare. So what does that tell you? That tells you something about at least my attitude, that I didn't think of my situation as being permanent, for one thing. And I didn't think of myself as a victim, even when I was not being treated well. Now, here's the key. Being a victim is an attitude, not whether or not you became somebody that got treated badly in some way. You know, they call us a victim when we're in an accident or if we're harmed in some way by other people. And I don't mean that way. You know, you can be in a position where you have been hurt in some way by another person because of their choices, and you didn't have any control over the choices they made that ended up hurting you. But you have an opportunity to make a decision on how you're going to react to that behavior that was given to you. So anybody that's been raped or whatever, please don't give me any bad comments telling me, yeah, I didn't ask to be raped. No, this is not that kind of a story. We understand that there are times when people get hurt by other people's choices, and we don't have a control over that. But we do have a control over how we're going to act after that happens. And that's what this is about today. I wanted to give you a good story because this is tantalizing, but it's also very important to your business. If you don't make a decision to have a different attitude about what you're doing in your life, you can very well absolutely sabotage your ability to be successful in business. So let me give you number one. Number one, once you have established you are a victim, it is almost impossible to establish yourself as someone in control. If you decide that you're a victim, in other words, you had no control over what they did, and you're going to decide to be helpless because of that, there's the real word there. Yes, you might have had a really bad thing happen to you, and it can be all kinds of things, including not being treated well in business or possibly even cheated. But the point I'm trying to make with this number one is that you don't have to be helpless. You can decide to be proactive. You can decide to take action to rectify the situation. Maybe it's even a matter of you can go to court against that person that wronged you. And that's how you decide you stay in control, even though that wrong thing was done to you. That's very, very important. Yes, something might have happened, but on the other hand, did you let yourself become helpless and believe you didn't have any kind of things you could do about it? Or did you say, okay, that happened, now I'm going to take some action towards my own betterment? That's the difference. You do not have to be helpless. And I have been raped. I do know how that feels, and I do know how you feel helpless. But you can also decide not to be helpless. And that is going to be really, really important when it comes to business. Because if you have an attitude of being a victim, you will be victimized more and more and more. And you'll never come out of that place of not feeling helpless. You will not come to a place where you feel like you're in control and you have any power. And that's seriously important. So decide first you're not going to be helpful. I mean, you're not going to be helpless. Number two, in order to be a victim, make it clear to someone that someone did something irreparably damaged you by it, and you have no way to repair it. You've got to think about that for a minute. Almost anything, except for if you were killed, which of course you can't come back from, almost everything can have some sort of a remedy. And sometimes it means that you have to walk away and still keep your power. That doesn't mean you didn't get damaged. That doesn't mean you didn't get hurt. That doesn't mean something that happened that was wrong. But sometimes it's just a matter of deciding that you're not going to be helpless. And it can mean that you have some action you can take, and it can also mean that you make a decision that you're not going to let it hold you back, but you're going to walk away. It's all a matter of what you decide to do and what fits that situation. But the major thing I want to point out is that deciding that you're a victim and deciding that it's irreparably damaged and that there's no solution, in other words, then you stay a victim. So let me give you number three. You will have a lot of sympathizers, but none of them will buy from you. If you go around, especially on social media, and Facebook is really very good for that, and go and say, oh, this happened to me, I'm feeling so bad about myself, come feel sorry for me. You might notice that you can go through my whole Facebook profile, you'll never find that kind of a post. I only have had this Facebook profile since middle 2017, and it was a backup profile. I was not using it as my main profile. I had one that I had started in 2009, but because I was a little bit too edgy with my political stuff, they took me down. They actually hacked me and then claimed that I was hacked, but they never allowed me to recover that account. Now, I could still be talking today about how bad I feel that I lost that profile, or I could do what I'm doing right now and making this my profile. And I'm here, and this is what I'm doing, and I'm adding value every single day in this profile. I'm not worrying about what happened to the other one. I'm not talking about it daily, because why would I? That is, again, showing me as a victim. Instead, I'm showing myself as someone in control and has my own power, regardless of what happened. I decided it was not going to shape my future business success. Do you get what I'm saying here? It's not going to shape my future business success, even though that was done. So let me give you number four. Only thing being a victim does is keep you stuck in a loser place or a little place. Just think about that, especially when it comes to business. Even though it seems in society today, they really love having people behave as victims. But you know what they're really doing is they want people to stay small. They want people to stay feeling like they don't have control, feeling like they don't have any kind of real answer to a solution to a problem. In other words, they don't want you to ever think for yourself. They don't want you to believe that you have any choices. And if you stay in that mentality of believing yourself to be a victim, there is no possible way you can succeed in business, because you have to have a belief that you have control. You have to have a belief that you can do something about where you are, because everyone starts in a place of not perfect and certainly not as much money as they want. If you have an attitude of being a victim, someone says, this will cost $100, and you say, oh, that's a ripoff. I don't want to pay that much money. Why aren't you giving it to me for free? Well, that's a victim attitude, right? Whereas a person that has control and believes that they can do something valuable with themselves and they get the same offer, here is my business, it's $100, and they say, oh, I can see the value of that. I want to join. See the difference? Same business, same amount of money, but I saw the value, if you do, of course. Now, not to say there are things out there that offer you something for nothing, but most businesses offer you something of value because that's the only way they can stay in business. And if you decide that you are a person of value yourself, then you see the value in others and in the businesses they offer. Now, maybe it's not a good fit. You could say that, and that doesn't take away your power to say that. But on the other hand, you don't want to say, oh, that's a ripoff. I don't want to pay $100. I want you to just give it to me free. Well, how do you get ahead in your business if you expect everything to just be handed to you? It doesn't work that way. You want somebody in your team that sees the value of what you're offering. And if they see the value, that is only because you're attracting it by who you are. And if you decide you are of value and you can attract not only businesses that have value, but people that have value, you have to start out believing that person right here has value. So I hope that you got something from this. If you did, I would love for you to give me a like, comment, and share. And if you would like to learn how I have learned how to be of value in my business, let's have a private talk. And I will be talking to you again tomorrow for a short video, and I'll see you again later. Bye for now.